Hi, I'm Sindhu from Sensen International. So today I will tell you if you purchase a reference electrode, either aqueous or non-aqueous from us, so how to preserve the electrodes. So first of all, you will get a package like this. So you will have to open it and then you have a pamphlet. So I would request you, so kindly preserve this pamphlet because this exactly tells you the procedure of how to preserve the electrode. And this is very useful and handy, so that even if you are not there and someone else is there in the lab, so they can still follow the procedure. So basically you will have a package like this. So and you need to remove this and this blue part. So this is this Teflon cap is there for the protection. So once you start using the electrode, you have to remove this Teflon cap and then you can start using it. And then, so once you start using the electrode, so I will not spoil this electrode, I'll just show you a electrode which is already used. So once you use an electrode, you should never keep it dry, otherwise you will be there will be cracks in the fret, and then that electrode goes bad. So once you start using the electrode, so you can have any conical flask or beaker which can be there in your lab. And so what you need to do is the beaker or the flask should be completely filled with 1 molar KCl in case if you are using an AgCl aqueous electrode. And then you need to preserve it and kindly ensure that it is tight so that there is no evaporation. And so this is how you preserve the electrode most of the times. But sometimes you would find that even when you preserve the electrode very nicely, the liquid in the compartment would be gone. So in this case, so what you need to do is we need to remove this and then we need to fill it with a solution that is 1 molar KCl, right? So for this, the biggest problem would be many a times a salts get gathered in the gaps, and if you try to open it and if you give too much of pressure, so this electrode might actually break. So you need to have a distilled water in a flask or in a Borosil container, and you just need to have the temperature of the water at about 35 or 40 degrees, not more. Leave the electrode for good 5 to 10 minutes. Okay, so I'll just leave this for 10 minutes. So it's been 5 to 10 minutes now. So I'm removing this. In case if it is slippery, you can use a tissue paper. Otherwise, you just apply little pressure and ta-da. So generally this won't happen. And now you need to have KCl solution. So kindly ensure you have a syringe with an extremely long needle. And there should be no air gaps when you fill the 1 molar KCl solution. And kindly use a needle which is very long. And then you need to fill this compartment with the solution. And kindly ensure there is no air gap when you fill the solution. So I am filling it very carefully. Almost there. So I'll do one thing. I'll just tap a little bit just in case if there is any air gap. And the solution should be to the brim. Okay. So kindly ensure one thing. There are no air gaps and the solution is filled till the brim. Because the problem is, even if there is a little air gap and you give too much pressure, the fret will break and the electrode goes useless and you have to purchase a new electrode. Just apply a little pressure and it's done. So this is how you would replace the 1 molar, you know, KCl solution if it dries off. So always ensure that you keep it in a 1 molar, you store it in a 1 molar KCl solution for an aqueous electrode. For the non-aqueous, you can refer to the leaflet and you can follow the same. Thank you so much.